A lot of people like to say that NASA's $22.6 billion budget, making up less than 0.5% of the federal budget, is a giant waste of resources. After all, instead of NASA, we could have a whole 11 more B-2 stealth bombers. Well, to all the haters, here are 13 everyday inventions we only have as a direct result of space exploration. Don't forget to let us know what you think of the video down in the comment section below, and let's jump in. If you wear glasses, are you glad that every time you drop them, they're not instantly covered in scratches? Well, if so, you have NASA to thank for those scratch-resistant lenses. The technology behind these lenses was originally developed by NASA for scratch-resistant astronaut helmets. Later, the agency would license the technology out to the Foster Grant Corporation. From there, they continued experimenting with scratch-resistant plastics, which today are in most sunglasses and prescription lenses. Sticking with things that help you see, the technology that allows for LASIK, you know, the thing where they shoot a laser at your cornea, was first developed to track astronauts' eyes during extended periods in space, in order to assess how humans' frames of reference were affected by weightlessness. This would later become the technology that tracks a patient's eye position throughout the surgery. Up next, if you live in earthquake-prone regions, are you glad your office building hasn't come tumbling down? Well, you've got NASA to thank for that. During a rocket launch, there can be a lot of turbulence and vibrations that could potentially break the rocket or the delicate instruments they carry. To combat this, in the 80s, NASA developed shock absorbers designed to protect equipment during space shuttle launches. Today, this same technology is in bridges and buildings in earthquake-prone regions across the country. If you like renewable energy, you're sure to like what comes next. Because it's a little hard to plug the ISS into an electrical socket when it needs to charge, NASA relies on solar power for the majority of their missions. As part of their need to power their space missions, NASA has invented and consistently improved new photovoltaic cells and shared these advancements with private companies to accelerate the commercial technology. Up next, do you ever wonder what astronauts drink when they're floating around in space? The average person needs about 3.5 liters of water a day. Back when the space shuttles were taking off from Cape Canaveral, it cost $50,000 to get a single kilogram to space. This meant if the astronauts brought all the water they needed with them, a typical crew of 6 astronauts would need more than $1 million in water every day. Luckily for NASA's accountants, their R&D teams figured out how to effectively recycle wastewater using iodine and cartridge filters, ensuring that astronauts had access to safe, tasteless water. Today, the ISS recycles 90% of its water, or more than 1,000 gallons a year. Back here on Earth, this filtering technology has become standard in hundreds of wastewater treatment facilities and commercial projects. Now let me switch things up and pose a challenging question. The space shuttle comes into land at more than 200 miles an hour, 30% faster than modern commercial airliners, and even faster than the Concorde. The runway is only 31 feet or 91 meters wide, leaving only about 60 feet or 18 meters of clearance on both sides. At such high speeds, if the shuttle turns by only a few tenths of a degree, it could go hurtling off the runway in a matter of seconds. Add to this factors like landing in the rain or a crosswind, and how do you keep the shuttle pointing straight down the runway? Well, after NASA scientists conducted extensive research on ways to minimize hydroplaning when vehicles slide uncontrollably on a wet surface, they discovered that by cutting grooves into the runway, they could significantly increase traction and channel water away from the landing zone, thus significantly reducing the risk of accidents. Today, many highways and airports have adopted this technology, and it saved thousands of lives. But these are all things that indirectly improve your life. So what about the things that really have a direct impact on your day-to-day life? Well, today, run-of-the-mill tires should last about 70,000 miles, and you have NASA to thank for that. After the Goodyear Tire and Rubber Company, using NASA research money, invented the material used in NASA's Viking Lander parachute shrouds, the company began using it in their tires. The material is stronger than steel and adds thousands of miles to the life of tires. And while we're on the subject of things in your everyday life, NASA research helped to invent the camera in your smartphone. In the 1990s, NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory invented a light miniature imaging system that required little energy in order to take high-quality photographs from space. This technology would later become the starting point for modern cell phone and computer cameras. And if you've ever walked into a hospital, rest assured that NASA's contributed here too. NASA's JPL developed digital imaging processing technology to enhance pictures from the moon landing and get them in higher definition. This would later become part of the underlying technology that makes CAT scans and MRIs possible. Even right after birth, NASA has your back. Today, more than 80% of American infants are fed baby formula. Back when NASA scientists were searching for a recycling agent to use during long space missions, they discovered a nutritious algae-based vegetable oil that is now used as an additive in more than 90% of infant formulas. If you're a bit older than an infant, you might remember how uncomfortable mattresses used to be. If so, you owe your restful nights to NASA researchers. The memory foam technology in millions of beds across the country was originally invented as a pad for astronaut seats that would mold to their bodies during the high G-forces of takeoff and landing, then return to a neutral state. This eliminated the need to customize seats to individual astronauts' body sizes. And when NASA scientists were tasked with developing insulation for the Apollo spacesuits that could hold up against the frigid vacuum of space, they developed new insulating materials that are widely used in home and commercial construction today. Last up, in the 80s, it was much more common for planes to crash because of a buildup of ice along vital control surfaces. And ice was a real threat to space shuttles too. NASA funding led to the development of a thermoelectric de-icing system called Thermowing that could heat the wings of the space shuttle to avoid icing problems, and it would later become widely used in commercial aviation. Well, hopefully you've learned some new ways NASA's funding has helped us back here on Earth. And plus, now you have a great video to send to people if you ever hear them saying NASA is a waste of money. If you like the video, be sure to check out our playlist here of some of our best uploads. And don't forget to subscribe so you never miss an upload. As always, have a great day. And remember, there is always more to learn.